This is Robert Ian with GoldSeek.com Radio. Censorship is one of the biggest threats individuals are facing today. As mainstream media struggles to uphold its ratings, audience, integrity, and share price, those who would seek to obtain their information elsewhere or provide their own interpretation of what is happening are under siege. Attempts are flourishing to regulate the internet, in other words, to stifle free speech and manage the collective memory of the population. There is a topic of discussion that periodically circulates on the web called the Mandela Effect, where some people seem to remember history different than it actually happened. What people don't remember, or save locally on their computer or in physical form, they often rely on their favorite search engine to retrieve. But what happens when that collective memory called the internet is given a digital lobotomy on certain topics, sometimes very subtle, to manage the information and long-term recall people eventually come to believe? This is why any regulation of the internet, no matter what it's called or disguised as, like net neutrality, is a serious threat to freedom, thought, and memory. I am unable to locate anywhere on the internet the actual video interview George Stephanopoulos gave several days after 9/11 in 2001, when he appeared on Good Morning America and explained in detail the plunge protection team and how the president and certain cabinet officials could manage the stock market through what is called the President's Working Group on Financial Markets. This is just one example of how important pieces of our history disappear. Yes, there are accounts of the interview, but not the interview itself. If I've missed it, I'd like to ask our listeners to email me a link. The email is office@conquerchange.com. A more recent example of how information that isn't wanted anymore can disappear quickly. CNN has been under fire regarding fake news reports. This past week, significant attention was drawn to their app in Apple's App Store. The report I heard mentioned that there were 9,000 reviews, mostly unfavorable, giving the CNN app a one-star rating. When I pulled up the app on my phone that Saturday, the number had grown to 12,000 negative reviews. I decided to post my own review, and when I checked the very next morning, the number of reviews had increased to 15,000. I checked again later that night, and miraculously, either Apple, CNN, or both had reset the ratings to 1,000 reviews. It still had a one-star rating, but a lot less reviews. See how easily history can be rewritten? I decided to repost my review, which was titled Four Lights, One Star. This is what I wrote. There is an episode of Star Trek: The Next Generation where Captain Picard is captured and tortured by enemy forces. His captor offers him relief if only he will proclaim there are five lights in front of him, when in fact there are only four lights. His captor wants him to deny reality and admit something that isn't so. In other words, he wants to psychologically break Captain Picard. Picard endures unspeakable tortures until the bitter end, where he defiantly proclaims, "There are only four lights." CNN, and by extension this app, is trying in desperation to make people deny reality and say Russia hacked the U.S. election, among other things, without providing any evidence except accusations and innuendo. Give it up already, CNN. Your paid actors blew their cover long ago by masquerading as real reporters. Poetic justice would be if the Justice Department refused to allow the AT&T Time Warner merger, unless Time Warner first had to divest itself of CNN, forcing CNN to stand alone in the free market and rise or fall on its own volition. The real fake news reporting of CNN must violate Apple's terms of service in some manner. We can only hope this app will be removed and banned from the App Store. But those kinds of actions will only be reserved for real alternative news sources and content creators across the social media spectrum who speak in opposition to the likes of CNN. As I've already indicated, the initial reviews have been completely vanquished from CNN's app history, which is just a minor example of how history can be completely and conveniently rewritten. And when inconvenient truths aren't being rewritten, they are often downplayed or ignored. Like the Reuters article that just appeared discussing how Russia's biggest bank just began physical gold trading on the Shanghai Gold Exchange. Reuters reports that Russia's biggest bank was granted international membership of the Shanghai Exchange in September of 2016, and in July of 2017 completed a pilot transaction with 200 kilograms of gold kilo bars sold to local financial institutions. The bank plans to expand its presence on the Chinese precious metals market and anticipates a total delivery of 5 to 6 tons of gold to China in the remaining months of 2017. That's one Russia story that likely won't make it into the 24/7 mainstream media news cycle and be repeated multiple times every hour ad nauseum. I wonder why. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com, reminding you to follow us on Twitter at ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.
Okay, Robert, thanks for another excellent installment. Well, that wraps up this week's GoldSeek.com radio episode. For two new big guests, be sure to check out next week's show. Until we talk to you again, have a great week.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.
The blockchain revolution is transforming the business world, and one startup promises exceptional returns to investors. That's why GoldSeek Radio is excited to support a unique ICO cryptocurrency offering that may present the investment opportunity of a lifetime. Monkey Capital, a unique investment company in Singapore and Hong Kong, both blockchain-friendly nations, is a leading decentralized hedge fund that will generate profits from SpaceX contracts, digital assets, and hostile takeovers. Their strategy includes Elon Musk-style ventures, like the $70 million supply contract contract for SpaceX through seed investment in Elite Aerospace. At the helm, CEO Daniel Mark Harrison has an established record of accomplishment, as well as accolades from the Wall Street Journal, Forbes, and TheStreet.com. Business partner Loud Capital is projected to return investors in excess of 40% per year. Plus, investors receive 10% of all revenues annually, and half of all income earned from activities are paid out to token holders. The unique token structure and solid legal foundation virtually ensure a cycle of perpetual wealth creation. Be sure to jot down ticker symbol MNY for trading on the user-friendly Waves platform, and COEVAL for pre-ICO options trading. Remember, your investment portfolio will thank you for a core position in Monkey Capital, symbol MNY.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.